Hello students, in this class we'll see booting. Booting means starting a computer. In very simple terms, you may say booting means starting a computer. If you are starting any computer, that means you are booting it. Rebooting means, or reboot means, to restart a computer. Now, if we'll go in more elaboration, in more detailed discussion, then booting again means loading operating system into memory. Memory means main memory, the RAM. Loading of operating system into memory. Okay. The first definition was simple. Starting a computer means booting. That's okay. Second definition or second thing that I'm telling is loading operating system into memory. It's not a complete statement. You might feel like this. Loading operating system into memory means what? So this is what exactly happens when a computer boots. Then why does it happen? Why the operating system get loaded into RAM? What is the need of it? So I'd like to tell you, you know this, that computer do everything with the help of instructions. For every single bit of thing, if small thing, big things, instructions are there which computer follow and it does the work. Another thing is everything, every kind of hardware, every operation, everything is controlled by operating system. Yes. So operating system is such a large software which handles, which controls everything in a computer. So in order to handle or control all the things, it need to be activated first. Yes. So during this process of booting, this happens. The operating system take command of everything. So you might ask, then where is operating system before booting? Yes. So here is some hidden things. Not hidden things, actually, some information should be there in your mind to understand all these things. You know the property of main memory or the RAM. It's a volatile memory. You know already what is volatile memory. Volatile memories are such memories, the content of which get vanished or it get cleared when the power supply is switched off. When you shut down a computer completely or when you turn off the power supply, the main memory or the volatile memory or the RAM get emptied, that everything in it get vanished. Fine. Then where are the things kept permanently? It is the secondary memory. It may be a floppy disk, which is no more used nowadays. Maybe a CD, maybe a pen drive, and the best secondary devices, of course, the hard disk. So normally everything gets stored or kept stored in hard disk, in laptops, desktops, and in handy devices, we have semiconductor memories like memory card, inbuilt memories are there to store everything else for permanent. Another thing you need to know is the relation or the connection between these devices. So you must know that there is a processor, the CPU, which controls, which handles everything. Processor is what? Processor, what is the major task of processor? The major task of processor is to, execute the instruction given by us. The major task. So for that, processor must get the instructions in order to execute it. Yes. From where does the instructions come to the processor? Then here comes the use of RAM or the main memory. In between there is a cache memory also. We are not going to discuss what is cache memory right now. So from RAM, the instruction and the data comes to processor. It processes it and accordingly everything happens in the computer or things work. And everything happens at a tremendous speed. Tremendous speed means millions of instructions per second. Several millions of instructions per second at this rate. It happens. And why do we need memory? These all things we have discussed while learning what is memory, what is their use and all. But still, since this is the requirement of this moment, so I'll tell you about this also. Secondary memories are used for permanent storage and they are comparatively very, very slow than the main memory or the processor. Whatever the speed of processor is, the secondary memory can't match the speed. So main memory do this work of providing data to processor at the fastest speed so that everything be fast. So the things from secondary memory need to be get loaded into primary memory, the main memory or the RAM, and then it goes to the processor, and then things work. Instruction cycle work like this. So what is the connection of this information with the booting? Yes, that's what I told you. The operating system get loaded from secondary memory to main memory, and then everything is started. When you switch on a computer, when you power on a computer, then it takes some time to start, okay? Whether you are starting a Windows machine or MacBook you are starting or Android machine you are starting, then it takes some time. What happens during this time? What things are there which happens during this time? That is the complete process of booting. That is in between whatever happens, this is the process of booting. So for different operating systems, there are different ways of booting. Different processes are there, different softwares are there, different instructions are there, which work, and then the machine gets started. So in order to simply understand what is booting, we'll first see the booting of MS-DOS. Why we are taking this MS-DOS as our sample? Because MS-DOS is one of the early operating system, is a small operating system, and it will be easier for us to understand it. Once we have understood what is the process of booting in MS-DOS, then we can go for the other things or other operating systems also. So let us begin. So in front of you, you can see a text is there, the MS-DOS boot process. I found it somewhere from the internet. Look, it was a good article, so it may take some time. It is very informative also, so listen it very carefully. The system boot sequence consists of a series of events that the system performs when it is turned on. It's not very simple English, but it's saying the same thing which I just said. Booting means simply when we turn on the computer, when it starts, that's called booting. This always start with a special boot program software, that is system BIOS ROM on the motherboard. Then from where it starts, as I said, that there must be something there in the processor to work with. Then when a computer is switched off, then there is nothing in the main memory, there is nothing in the processor, then what does it actually start executing? What is the first thing that is to start executing? So I'd like to tell you here, ROM, R-O-M, ROM, read-only memory. It's another type of primary memory, which contains basic input-output softwares or services. Basic input-output service. Means to start a computer, there is a vital programs are there, which are stored in ROM chip, read-only memory chip, the things of which cannot be altered. You know already that the data or instructions which are stored in ROM cannot be changed. And that's why its name is only read-only memory. So the program which is stored in ROM is known as BIOS, basic input-output services, which is there in the motherboard. The BIOS performs several steps to test the system and make it ready before an operating system can be loaded. Another important thing, before the operating system should be loaded, the things should be working properly, means everything should be okay. Then only operating system will be loaded. Means if you're calling some guest, then you see that things are okay. Then you call your guest. The same way, BIOS first test the hardware, whether everything is fine or not. And if it is fine, this is the first step. This is also known as POST, P-O-S-T, POST, power on self-test. When you power on the system, you might have seen that the keyboard's light is blinked, mouse light blinks, and other things are tested. Although we cannot see in detail, but it works, taste the things. This is called post, power on self-taste. And then start the process. So now you have likely understood that bios first test the thing, and then after everything is okay, then the operating system get loaded from the secondary device to the primary memory. But in between, there is something which we really need to know. We need to know about this, the master boot record. What is this? This is part of booting process. And in order to understand it in detail, you need to know this also. So we'll switch back to that point also. To proceed further, we need to have idea about this also, master boot record. So what is this? Let us start. When you turn on your PC, the processor attempts to begin the process of processing data. As soon as we switch on the machine, the processor needs something to process. It needs to start processing. But since the system memory is empty, but since there is nothing in RAM, the processor doesn't really have anything to execute. Processor ke paas kuch bhi nahi hota hai kaam karne ke liye. Then what? Or even begin to know where to look for. Even processor has no idea of where to look for the instructions and all. It has nothing in it. So to ensure that PC will always boot regardless of BIOS code, both chip and BIOS manufacturer develop their code so that processor once turned on, always start executing the place this. It's telling that therefore BIOS also has the instruction. The developer, the makers of the hardware, the makers of the computers make the BIOS and the BIOS program and load it there. And it is set in it that this memory location should be looked for the instruction. This is the memory location in hexadecimal. Okay. You know that the memory location is something. Memory has some location. So from where to start? So this is the location from where to start to read the instructions to process. So this is the memory location. Similarly, every hard disk, as I said, is the best storage device so far. And everything normally is loaded in hard disk. In earlier days, floppies were used. CDs, DVDs were also used. They are also, right now also they are used. Pen drives can be also used, but hard disk is the best device. So we'll see. As per hard disk, every hard disk must have a consistent starting point where the key information is stored about the disk. You must have understood now this, that every hard disk is what is storage place. So in that storage place, there must be a special location from where we could start, from where we can. It's a similar to a book having the index page, table of content, you know, chapter 1 in page number this, chapter 2 in page number that, this topic in page number this, kind of this. So we normally find this page in the beginning. The same way, hard disk also contains a special location where these vital informations are stored normally. So we'll see more about hard disk also in this class, such as number of partition, what type they are, etc. What kind of information is stored in that place? Means the hard disk is partitioned in how many, partitions. What is partition? So dear students, hard disk is a large storage device. So that large storage device is divided into smaller parts for better management. Then those different parts are known as partition. It's a similar to, you think of a hall, big hall, very big hall, you think of this. So you can't use the hall if you have for living a normal hall. But if you have a large hall, then you can divide that hall and you can make one room as kitchen, one room as bedroom, one room as drawing room, and one room as something else. So this way, the large hard disk, 1 terabyte hard disk, 1 TB, 2 TB hard disk, or 500 GB is also very large space, can be divided into a smaller part of 100 GB, 50 GB, or 50 GB, 20, 200 GB, 500, different sizes also it can be divided. So those things are known as partition. So in how many partition it is divided, what type of partition is there. So every kind of detail is stored somewhere. Okay. Where is that place? So that is the special place. We'll see more about it. So there also must be somewhere, some place where the BIOS can load the initial boot program and start the process of loading the operating system. It means that there must be a special place from where everything must start. The place where these information or this information is stored is called master boot record. That location of the hard disk is known as MBR, which is also known as master boot sector, or even just boot sector. Master boot record, master boot sector, or boot sector, all are same thing. Do not confuse the master boot sector with volume boot sector. So let us not discuss these things, otherwise the things will be elaborated more. So let us see a few more information. The master boot record is always located at cylinder 0, head 0, and sector 1. This is the location of hard disk. If you know more about hard disk, then you must be knowing these things, and if not, then you need to really learn or study hard disk. What is cylinder, what is sector, what is track, then also you can understand this. So it's telling that master boot record is always located at cylinder 0, head 0, and sector 1. So you can see this diagram of hard disk to know more. You know that hard disk has platers, and every hard disk has tracks and sectors are there. So you see, this is one track. Track means it is a concentric circle kind of thing. Concentric circle, track. You know, running track is there in a stadium. The same way tracks are there. Different plates are there. Every plate has tracks, and the track form a cylinder kind of shape, because we have multiple disks. See, this cylinder C is written. So tracks actually form the cylinder. And see, every track is further divided into sector. Look at this, sector is there. Okay, you see the track is there, sector is there, cylinder is there. This is spindle over which the plates are stored. This is read and write head, read write head. So since we have multiple plates, so need multiple heads also. So that's why it is telling that master boot record is always cylinder 0, head 0, and sector 1. So cylinder 1, from wherever it is starting, this is cylinder 1, then cylinder 2, or track 1, track 2, track 0, track, it starts from track 0, then track 1, track 2, like this, and track, sector is 1, and head is 0. The first head is there for it. So now you have understood. If there is a hard disk, then it has a boot sector, and that boot sector is fixed normally. It's fixed place. This is the consistent starting point that the disk will always use. Ek consistent place hai jo use hota hai. When a computer starts and the BIOS boots the machine, it will always look at this first sector for instructions and information on how to proceed with the booting process and load the operating system. So this master boot record or this place contains everything, every information regarding booting. The master boot record contains the following structure. Although it doesn't need to go in much detail, but still I'd like to discuss it for your better information. So master boot record contains master partition table. Now what is master partition table? So as just now I have discussed, partition is something, if you have large memory, large storage, secondary memory, then it need to be divided. Although if you don't need, then you can't divide. You do not divide. But if always dividing always is good for better management of the data. So we normally divide the hard disk, and how many partition the hard disk is divided. What is the name of every partition, like C drive, D drive, E drive, F drive, G drive? We see, no, those are the different partition of the same disk. You just see one more thing here. I'll show you what is partition. You just see this. Window plus E, when you press window plus E, it shows you this is the partition. Okay, if you want to know more about your storage, then just right click here and go to manage. This manage will tell you more about your storage. Huh? Look at, go to the disk management. Although this is the place where you should not go always, but still for information I'm telling you. So it's telling you that different things are there. Disk zero, disk one. In this, in my laptop, I have two disk. Disk zero, this is one of the disk SSD is there. Disk one is SSD hard disk. SSDs are of different types. So this is one type of SSD, which is already there. This is of 120 GB only. And extra hard disk is there of 500 GB. And you can see that the main SSD means solid state device. This is a fast storage. So the operating system is loaded in drive C. This whole memory I have left for operating system. Keep it for operating system. And I have a hard disk, SSD hard disk, which is additionally added to it. I have divided that hard disk into two partitions. One is D drive of around 400 GB. And for data, I have kept 100 GB. That's enough. So here you can see every detail of it. Here also it shows you that what kind of layout is, what type of partition is there, and other things. So this is partition. So what is master partition table? This is small bit of code that is referred to table contains a complete description of the partition that are contained in the hard disk. Ek hard disk mein kitne partition hai, uska sara detail ye rakhta hai. When the developer designed the size of master partition table, they left just enough room for four partition. We can have only four major partition, okay? Master partition, we can divide, mainly we can divide a disk into, as per this article, we can have four major partition, primary partition. Hence the four partition, four physical partition limit, that's a limit. Only four, but still that's the major partition, after which we can extend the partition also. For this reason and no other, a hard disk may only have four true partition, four major partition, or four primary partition could be there, physical partition. And any additional partition must be logical partition or extended partition, okay, which is further, primary partition can be further divided into a logical partition. One of this partition is marked active, indicating that means among all other partitions, one of them is decided that this is the main room. Okay, this is the active partition, indicating that this is one that the computer should use to continue the boot process. And this in primary partition, the operating system is loaded. Okay, and from where the booting process starts. Now another thing is master boot code. What is master boot code? Let us see. Master boot record is the small bit of computer code that the BIOS loads and executes to start a boot process. This master boot code is the program which is there in BIOS, and it tells that from where the booting has to be started. This code, when fully executed, transfers control to the boot program stored in the boot active partition to load the operating system. Means first the code in the BIOS is executed, and then it tells that now you take the charge and you control everything, and it takes charge to the boot record in the primary partition. Okay, the partition, and then operating system starts. So due to great importance of the information stored in master boot record, should it become damaged or corrupt in some way, serious data loss can occur. Okay, so master boot record mein nuksan hone se bahut dikkat hai. The master boot code is the first program executed when you turn on the PC, and is often the target of virus. You must have heard about the boot sector virus. In order to understand master boot record, it's enough here. Okay, so this much information is enough regarding master boot record. Now let us come back to the booting process. So once the BIOS has completed testing the system configuration, it begins the process of loading operating system. The BIOS accomplishes this by searching the installed drives for a master boot record in which it contains is contained in the boot code. It simply means that now the BIOS has completed its work of testing and all. Then it goes to the master boot record and look for the different partitions, how many drives are there, C drive, D drive, E drive is there, and which drive contains the operating system. Once found, the boot code is executed and the system is boot into the operating system. If it gets the master boot record, then it starts the process booting. When looking for this master boot record, the BIOS will search for the boot devices or the drives. When it searches for the master boot record, it also looks for the boot device or the drive in which the operating system is actually. Because if you have partitioned a table into C, D, E, F drive, then which drive contains the operating system is also important. Look. In order to, the BIOS will search for the boot device in order to specify in BIOS. Yes, BIOS also contain one more thing. I forgot to discuss this. BIOS contain the sequence or the list of boot devices. I mean, it has to boot from CD, it has to boot from floppy, it has to boot from a pen drive, or it has to boot from hard disk. This is set there in the BIOS. You can change it. Okay, F1 or F2, when you start a computer, you might have seen in your screen, press F1 to or F2 to change the boot sequence or to enter the BIOS setup. And then from there, you should not do it unless you know more about or good about it, but otherwise just leave it. But I just want to tell you, you can set that from which secondary device we have to load the operating system. That is set in BIOS, about which here it is discussed. It searches for the boot device in order to BIOS configuration setting controlling this aspect of the boot sequence. If it cannot find a boot device, it will terminate with error. If no boot device is there, if hard disk is there, but it does not contain any operating system, then it will tell the error and it will, about the process. If the operating system is MS-DOS or any variant of Windows, other than Windows NT, because Windows NT and 2000 are different way of starting, but if it's a normal window, then that starts out by booting the DOS. First DOS is loaded and then Windows is loaded. Okay. So, if you are booting to Windows, additional steps are performed. So, if you have once understood DOS, then you can also understand the Windows operating system also, how it is booted. Now, here's the step. First step is the BIOS have completed the test and setup function. First step. The next step is the process of master boot record, examining the master partition table. It looks for the master partition table. It must determine if there is extended DOS partition. Then if the master boot extended partition is, it loads the extended partition table that describes the first logical volume. This extended partition table examined. So if point to another extended partition, it's lengthy text, no need to be. So it actually looks for the master boot record, and there if it is a bootable disk, it has got operating system, then the operating system start loading from there. And if it is not there, then it will halt with the error message. And the fifth step, the master boot record sector loaded into memory and tested, the boot is contained in the controller render process. Now the BIOS hand over the charge to the operating system. During this step, the boot code searches for the root directory for these files. If you are looking for the MS-DOS, then io.sys, MS-DOS.sys, and command.com are executed. And then they do their work, after which config.sys is executed, which contains configuration things, and then autoexe.batch file is executed, which automatically execute. And this is how the computer get booted. If you want to know more about the booting process in Windows, you can see the step-by-step process of booting in Windows also. So this was the thing about the booting. In DOS, you have to remember these three files. and they do their work. And what are their work? You can find it if you will study in detail. So thank you, dear students.